So the Apple Vision Pro hype is literally real, and we have been seeing people trying out the Vision Pro in extreme scenarios. We have Casey Neistat, who is skateboarding with the Vision Pro. We have people skydiving wearing them. Vision Pro, Vision Pro, Vision Pro. Vision Pro is everywhere now. Now, while recording the video, we have got an official statement from Mark Zuckerberg that the Quest 3 is better than Apple Vision Pro as a product. But do you think that's really the case? Let's find out. So the Vision Pro OS allows users to control apps with eyes and fingers, and that's what makes it an amazing VR headset. Now, Apple calls it spatial computers instead of VR headsets because they believe that that's going to be the future of our computers or desktops. Apple is positioning the Vision Pro as a full-fledged computer that could work as an alternative to your desktop or computers. Then I thought, we don't have our Vision Pro yet, but we do have our Quest 3. I'm seeing people trying out the Vision Pro in different conditions, and I just wanted to try that out with the Quest 3. And during the test, I was YouTube, I did multitasking, I did editing, and I even played badminton wearing those headsets. And people just made fun of me. Just kidding. Okay, so a quick disclaimer. The reason why we are betting on this tech as a company is because we believe that it is going to be the future. Spatial computing devices and VR headsets are going to replace the traditional computers sooner than we think. We at Rigbetter Labs are immersed in the development of AR and VR for robots for years now. These devices will revolutionize how we interact with the world around us. Just a few years back, people used HMI screens to teach pendants how to control robots. But with the invention of IoT, we have shifted to apps and softwares on our computers. Looking forward, we see a future where you don't even have a screen to interact with your robots. We imagine a time when the technology becomes as commonplace as wearing glasses or even having a chip implanted to your brain, like a Black Mirror episode. Once we reach this pinnacle of technology, you will be able to control your robots by just looking at them, or even teleport yourself virtually from any part of the world. Stick around to the video till the very end to see an exciting peek on how we integrate VR and AR in robotics. So this is not a review of Meta Quest 3. If you want to watch the full review, you can watch this. This video is more likely my experience on Meta Quest 3 for a day and tell you the practicality of these headsets and is it practical for you to wear them or not. Now the problem with the Vision Pro is that it costs your heart and your kidney at the same time. And I am here to tell you why there is so much hype around the Vision Pro and should you buy the Vision Pro or you are better off with the Quest 3. We will make it easy for you, so stick to the video till the very end and let's go. Understand that you need to adjust these straps according to your convenience. If you don't, you'll start getting fatigue even after a very short duration of time. So adjust them according to your liking. Now I have set up the Meta Workrooms of our office and now I will start editing live in the Workrooms with my YouTube playing on the second screen. I generally edit on Premiere Pro and I tried the Workroom feature and I want to tell you that this feels a bit laggy. If you could see my YouTube screen, it's lagging behind. But there's a catch. You see, earlier I thought it was the Quest 3 which was lagging behind. But when I recorded my workspace at night, if you could see my screen, it was running perfectly. And that's when I came to know that it was an internet bandwidth problem. You see, during the day when I recorded the clip earlier, around 15 people were using the internet and that's why a huge amount of bandwidth was consumed and my Quest was lagging behind. Another thing I want to highlight is that I'm hearing people say that the Quest 3 only has controllers while the Vision Pro has gesture controls. By the way, agar tumhe janna hai ki ye statement kisne diya hai, to niche comment karo. Guys, the Quest 3 also has gesture controls and I rarely use controllers in my daily usage. The hand gestures just works as seamlessly in the Quest 3. Sure, the controllers are preferred when you're playing games, but for normal usage, gesture controls just gets the job done. Second, I tried watching TV while wearing the headset. It didn't feel like the audio is coming early and the video inside the headset plays late. Yeah, there is a bit of a blurriness and I don't know we will be able to see that in the recording, but yeah, I can confidently say that it is not as good as you are seeing in the recording. Look guys, the reason why you are seeing an extremely clear pass-through in the Vision Pro is because when you record your screen, it records in full quality, but when you see the screen in actual real time, it feels a bit blurry. This happens in Quest 2, this happens in Quest 3, and it is probably happening in the Vision Pro 2. One of the most irritating things what I found about the Quest 3 is that when you record the screen, for the most part you are getting the full vision. But when you see the recorded clip on your computer, the upper part just crops out and what you see is the middle part and the bottom part. So while recording the video, I'll have to align my head upwards accordingly. So now I'm going to play badminton wearing the Quest 3. But first, I'll play badminton
without wearing the Quets to tell you that I can play badminton. Oh, the sports mall.
Oh, are yaar. Meri galti nahi thi. It was air. It was the wind.
I played so well that the shuttlecock went on the roof. रेडी आप मेरे को रिकॉर्ड करो यू कांट प्ले इन करंटली आई एम नॉट एबल टू प्ले बिकॉज विंड इज टू मच हियर. There is a bit of a latency in the Quest 3, so let's try it out again. Let me turn off YouTube, and I'm feeling there's a bit of distraction due to YouTube. वो double double दिख रहा है जिसके वजह से मेरे को No, I'm not able to play, guys, because when there's rapid movement in the Quest 3, there's too much latency and the objects which are moving rapidly, it seems to be replicating. Like the objects start to duplicate when there's a rapid movement. So no, you cannot play badminton in the Quest 3.
Okay, so the reason why I was not able to play badminton in the Quest 3 was because first, there was so much wind, and second, when there is rapid movement inside the Quest 3, you can literally feel the latency, man. Like everything just started doubling up and I just couldn't identify where exactly the shuttlecock is. Now I don't know if you could see that in the recording, but yeah, there is latency and yeah, you cannot play badminton in the Quest 3. Another thing I want to highlight is that when you use the Quest 3 in pass-through mode for a longer duration of time, the upper part starts heating up a lot. By the way, this also happens while playing games. So yeah, this headset also heats a lot. Now you might have thought people are taking the Vision Pro to metros while driving and even skydiving. But why didn't they try that outdoors tests on Quest 3? Reason being, when you move far away from your home position wearing the Quest 3, the screen starts wiggling up aggressively and everything just restarts. Meanwhile, in the Vision Pro, we have a feature called as travel mode, which basically what does is that it disables the gyroscopic sensors and you can move freely around wearing them. Well, this was a quick brief on our experience with the Quest 3 and our thoughts on the Vision Pro. This was no way a comparative analysis. These were just our thoughts. But do let us know in the comment section what you think about these headsets. Until then, this is Madhur signing off and I'll see you in the next one. Pew, pew.